It's already been over a year again, but now I finally have a new desk setup for you. Of course, when moving into my new apartment, where I now have a full studio room dedicated to working and filming, I also had to fit it out with a new desk setup that I enjoy working at. Normally, my desk is facing the inside of the room, but because I didn't have enough room to film all of the angles of the setup, I did place it against the wall for some shots. As always, let's start with the monitor. This is the Lenovo Q27H10, and I mostly chose it for two reasons. For one, it's actually among the cheapest, if not the cheapest display that comes with a 2560 by 1440 resolution at 27 inches, while also supporting a single cable connection with charging over USB-C. With that, I can just plug a single cable into my laptop when sitting down at my desk, and my laptop is charging while having both the monitor and peripherals instantly connected. And the second reason is aesthetics. As you can see, there are slim uniform bezels all around the screen without any visible logos, which I find makes the setup look extremely sleek. The monitor is mounted to a white monitor arm by a Chinese brand called North by You, which has a terribly tacky logo, but fortunately you can take all of the logo stickers off without any residue. For only 50 euros, the quality is outstanding with easy spring-loaded adjustment. It also holds the weight of the monitor just fine. When you want a white monitor arm, your options are rather limited, but I'm very happy with this one. It looks good also because of the integrated cable management that hides all of the cables inside, and the side positioning that makes it look like the monitor is floating. And it also allows me to easily move the monitor up to place my laptop under it should I need two screens. On top of the monitor is a BenQ Screenbar Plus, which is a light bar that A. relieves eye strain, and B. illuminates the desk at night. It's easily powered with the USB port at the back of the monitor, and comes with a little control poke with a knob to control the brightness and color temperature. There's also a button that adjusts it to the lights in your room automatically. In addition to the screenbar, I also have a Tomins lamp on the desk that is mostly there for decoration. It has an RGB Philips Hue bulb in it that, like all the lights in my studio, can be adjusted in the app. To the left of the monitor is my laptop, which is placed in a vertical laptop stand by Macaulay. It makes the laptop take up less space on the desk and also looks nice. Plus, it doesn't block the ventilation holes on the bottom of the laptop like most of these stands do. I still have access to a USB port and the SD card reader at the front, while the single USB-C connection to the monitor is on the back. To make the laptop not turn off while the lid is shut like this, you of course have to turn off the setting that makes it go to standby when closing it. Fortunately, this can be set exclusively for when it's charging, so it still goes to standby when I close it without being plugged into the monitor. The laptop I have is a Dell XPS 15 with a 6-core i7, 32GB of RAM, a GTX 1050 Ti, and 1.5TB of SSD storage. Now that the new MacBooks are out, I definitely want to try one of those at some point to see what benefits they could bring to my workflow. But because I use Premiere and Adobe CC and none of Apple's apps, the answer to whether it will truly be much faster is a bit more complicated. But for now, I still really like the XPS 15. It's fast, really well built, and looks amazing. In my opinion, it's still the best all-around Windows laptop you can buy, that strikes the right balance between performance and not cutting any other corners with a really good keyboard and trackpad, for example. And of course, it also has a carbon fiber dbrand skin with my logo on it. If you want to know more about what I think, I also made an initial and long-term review video on it. The vertical laptop also perfectly doubles as a neat headphone stand. The headphones on there are my trusty old Sony XB950N1s. They definitely aren't among the best wireless noise-canceling headphones out there anymore, but they still work and the noise cancelling is also not too bad for taking them on the go. I just haven't really felt the need to upgrade them yet. Let's talk about the other peripherals as well. The keyboard is a 60% keyboard from Royal Clutch called the RK61. If you want a wireless mechanical keyboard, your options are actually still rather limited, especially if you want one in white that also doesn't cost a fortune. For me, this one ticked all the boxes and I still thoroughly enjoy it. It has brown switches and is of course super compact and doesn't take up a lot of space on the desk. It's extremely well built with no flex at all and really pleasant to type on. The only downside is that the battery life isn't that great. It only lasts a couple of days on a single charge. But fortunately you can easily charge it over USB-C. Now that I have a more minimal setup, I also wish that I would have gone for white backlighting instead of blue. The mouse I have is the Logitech MX Master 3, which I've also done a full review on. It's a really expensive mouse, but all of the extra features it has with the second scroll wheel do make for some nice workflow improvements for productivity. It's also extremely comfortable. The battery lasts forever and I can charge it with the same USB-C connection as the keyboard. Below the mouse I have the Carpio from DeltaHub. It's a small wrist rest for the mouse to counteract the likelihood of getting carpal tunnel. While I haven't had any issues with it myself yet, it's better to be safe than sorry. All of these things rest on a felt desk pad that is also from DeltaHub. It's nice for the mouse to glide on and also protects the delicate desk surface underneath. Plus, it also looks very good and the quality is a lot better than a lot of the no-name products you can find, especially with the stitching on the sides. Apart from this, the last things on the desk are a Rubik's Cube and a small cactus for decoration. Speaking of the desk, it's still the IKEA Skarsta sit-and-stand desk that I've had for a while. It's not the nicest desk, and especially the quality of the tabletop isn't that great, but it's a very cost-effective solution to getting the ability to also work while standing without having to shell out a lot of money. It is all manual though, which makes me use that functionality less than I'd want to. I do plan on upgrading to a full electronic standing desk that also has a nicer natural wood tabletop, but unfortunately that cooperation fell flat for this video, so it didn't make it in. Of course, I also tried to hide all of the cables on the underside of the desk so nothing is visible except the single cable of the power strip going to it to power everything. The single cable setup with the laptop and all wireless peripherals also helped to keep clutter to a minimum. The chair I have is the IKEA Longfjäll, which looks good and is comfortable. That also sits on a plastic mat to protect the wood floor underneath. This video is supported by Artlist, and that's pretty amazing because I actually already used their service for client projects before they reached out to me, but now I also use it for my own channel. If you're also interested in content creation, then you know how hard it is to find good music that you can also legally use for video. Artlist makes that super easy with straightforward licensing and a curated selection of top-notch music tailored for video creators. No more searching and no more being unsure if you're allowed to use the music. And now they also have a new service called ArtGrid that does the same for stock footage. If you want to try them out, there's a link below. If you use that, you get 2 months free and also support me in the process. Of course, this setup is just one part of the new studio I have. If you've watched some of my last videos, you've already seen parts of it. It's really great to finally not have to work and sleep in the same room anymore, and to keep all of my camera gear accessible. If you want a full studio tour, make sure to let me know in the comments. In the meantime, you can of course find all of the things I mentioned in this video linked in the video description below. If you enjoyed this video, you know which buttons to press, and don't forget to press that follow button on Twitter. I'm Brian, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.